What is it that you hope people see in this series? And what is it, I mean, are there any nerves at all about, you know, being back on screen after a break?
No, I don't think it's about that. Like I said, this is a story that I wanted to be a part of. Mm. This is like what I go through every day. This is the motherhood and the mentalhood of life today. And that is what we're portraying, and that is what we're telling the audience. So I'm happy and I'm proud that I'm a part of a show like this.
Every day is madness in a mom's life.
Nikki!
और उस madness में सब कुछ right करने में लगी रहती है वो.
Miss Kanpur, फिर तीन बच्चे.
I am one of the mummies and these are my babies.
हमारी dream team का क्या हुआ?
मैं dream करता हूँ, तुम team कर लो ना.
Mahisha, what is this? 98%?
I want my child to be one with nature.
नहीं करेंगे तो क्या करोगे?
TV तोड़ दूँगी.
नहीं नहीं.
So just because I'm a working woman does not mean that I'm not a good mother.
Yes. So ever since their trailer dropped, the show has been getting a tremendous amount of buzz. Mentalhood premieres on ZEE5 on the 11th of March. I've got with me here the cast of the show, Shilpa, Shukla, Karisma Kapoor and Sandhya, Mridul. Welcome. To start things off, I thought I'd do a little fun activity. And a lot of people have actually written in with questions for you guys.
Oh, damn it.
Okay. So these are actually questions about parenthood.
Okay.
I know that the two of you are.
Apply
yourselves to the best of your ability in this one, okay? I have caught my son stealing money. How should I deal with him?
Split it.
Shilpa, have you ever stolen as a child?
You know, yes. And you know, what did I steal? What? I stole a flower from a garden. And I cannot. So
that's not stealing.
That's not stealing.
Really,
realized that someone in their own garden has, you know, this beautiful flower, and it was a very rare kind of a flower. And when I plucked it, I remember crying for 2 hours because I thought it did belong to their garden and my, so
oh my
things
God.
Like that. Yeah.
Wow. Sandy, you're the evil one in this drive. I'm just saying.
Dekho, suno, I have stolen money from my father's wallet, but it was because my brother wanted money.
Oh. Okay. I can't understand my kids' lingo. Actually, I can't understand this generation's lingo. What do I do? Let me first ask you guys, is your slang on fleek?
Very.
Shilpa's already like looking, she's got a very like worried expression.
Yeah, because this is like serious test.
I'm going to give you guys a bunch of words. All new lingo, new millennial Gen Z.
Oh my
lingo.
God.
Okay. Easy one. What does the word snack mean?
Snack.
Samosa?
Extra.
Extra means exaggerated, like too much, really loud.
Over the top, yeah. ODT.
Extra nervous.
YOLO.
Oh, I know this one.
I'm tongue-tied.
You only live once.
Salty.
Namkeen.
Namkeen person.
Samandar mein nahake.
Translations. Haan. I'm asking okay. You it's lingo.
So salty means that lingo. Only, na namkeen type.
No.
Sorry, then I don't know.
Okay, we really need to get on with this lingo.
If your niece, nephew or daughter or son come to you and say, listen, XYZ has been ghosting me.
Haan, yeah, when you're ignoring them. We know ghosting.
We are still going through it.
Yeah.
What daughter, niece ghosting. And nephew?
Shook.
Shook.
No, no looking off camera.
In, okay, use
look,
it, okay,
use it in a sentence, we'll tell you.
If I use it in a sentence, it's damn easy.
No, shook me.
Man.
Shook. Like, I'm shook.
I'm shaken up.
Yeah. That's so, I'm shook. It's the way you say it.
But that's wrong English.
No, but that's the new age.
I'm shook.
Yeah. Like, if something crazy happens,
she
like,
shook me up. Like, oh my God.
Not I'm shaken up, I'm shook.
I'm shook.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm shook. Just go home today and tell your daughter.
I'll tell you one. Guys, are you ready to dip?
But Sandhya, Shilpa, at what age, hypothetically, do you think is a good age for a child to have a phone?
I think a child should never have a phone. I mean, I grew up without a phone and I had a great life.
Actually, all of us did. Yeah. All of us did.
I went out, I played games, I did stuff, I lived life.
I don't think that's an option anymore.
Mera to man karta sabke phone tod do main.
But I also feel that we are like, for us, it's a migration into technology.
Yeah.
For these kids, you know, they are the natives. They're born in.
They're born in technology.
My kids are very young. I don't have time to go to the gym. How do I keep myself fit?
I think you could do many things. I mean, in your building compound, go for a walk. Walk up the steps, up and down. I used to do things like that. Yoga, you can do yoga.
I do my self yoga class almost daily. If I can't do it, I mean, I can't go to a class and I definitely, I can't start my day till my first 1.5 hours, I can't talk to anybody. So those are the days I'm really grateful that I'm not a mother because I don't think I would be able to handle it. I'm enough of a child for myself.
What about you, Shilpa?
So sometimes I dance, sometimes I do yoga cross trainer, or sometimes I do nothing, sometimes I just walk. Yeah.
My daughter hides things from me and doesn't share them with me. How do I break this barrier? This I feel like we all did with our parents.
I think we all went through a phase. I think it's the most important thing is for children to talk to us, we have to talk to them.
My kids love fast food, but I want them to eat homemade food. How do I make homemade food cool?
I think it's something that we have to ingrain in our children. Like, I've been quite a disciplinarian at home. Like, you know, you have to eat at home. And I think outside food and fast food is only a treat.
But how do you make homemade food cool?
When kids are younger, you have to make the food look interesting. So, you know, whether it's even if they eat like a toast and you give them little gajar, you know, and you make two eyes and a little mouth. I remember doing that with my kids, you know, and make it look cute and, yeah. And you know, fun. So, no.
And put broccoli in my buns.
Let's get into the show, guys, because your trailer looked absolutely lovely. You guys are looking stunning. The show seems really interesting. Tell me, what was it about the idea that you guys decided we have to be a part of it?
Well, for me, I think it was just so synonymous with what I was going through as a mother, as a parent. And there's so much learning in the story and so much emotion, you know, from a mother's point of view, from as in parenting, but also as the woman's point of view of each character, of what they go through is what we see in life behind closed doors and in front. So I think it really moved me, and each episode has a story to tell and a learning behind it.
Shilpa?
For me, it's a very unique story. But for me, mostly what worked was Karisma Kohli, the director, and Ekta Kapoor together. And then I came to know that it is also her digital launch. Then I came to know there's Sandhya Mridul also. Then I come to know there's Tillotama, Shome, Dinu Moria, Sanjay Suri. And I was like, ye to, you know.
But it's also largely women telling women's stories.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Predominantly a woman set up.
And so there is more faith that it would be told, like, you know, in the right way, in the right light. You know, and so that's how it was. Yeah.
Sandhya, I know you've played mom on screen before, but for this show, for example, you're Momzilla.
Yeah.
How do you sort of even, like, who do you look to for inspiration for a role like that?
If I name her, she'll kill me.
Oh, okay. I can wager a guess though, but I'm not going to say it out loud.
So, I mean, for me, doing this show was really like a dedication to my friends. I mean, what's the point of me having been around them and seen them go neurotic if I'm not going to use it on screen?
Right.
So I was like, okay, let's give this a shot. And trust me, I have had a lot of inspiration around me. Mm-hmm. I have seen these tantrums that I have thrown. I have seen my friends crack up and break down. It's like, guys!
Does that sound like, you had those experiences?
Yeah, of course. I mean, you know.
And that there are times like I my character is always under threat of being completely over the top. So I used to be like, guys, you know, and they used to be like, so many times I asked her.
She'd be like,
and then I remember some of my friends just freaking out for nothing, you know, sometimes on the chat, eat it! And I was like, oh my God, she's so scary. But sometimes it's just so exhausting for them, you know, it's real.
It's
and my
real.
Heart would
it's
go
real.
Out to them. It's not easy being a mother. I think that's what just scared me off completely.
And I think all the characters are very real. They're human.
All the characters,
you know,
in
they're
this.
Not perfect. They have their imperfections.
It's
which,
fun.
You know, everyone has.
And it's not just mothers. It's not the story of mothers we are telling. It's the story of women.
Women, exactly.
It's the story of what they go through. Just as mothers, as human beings.
Yeah.
Whether it's a sexless marriage, or which is a big thing that nobody talks about. It has to be spoken about. It is something that's there. And it's a very real thing. And you know, so there is a lot of things that come up that women go through, not just only mothers. So I think it's just extremely relevant. And I love doing things like that. Even Goddesses for me was that. You know, it's important to get these stories out, and I think women are so vibrant and colorful, it's always fun.
What I also love is that this cast is so interesting, right? And on set, was it like you guys found a new sisterhood of sorts? I know there's Dino, I'm very aware, but I'm saying
he was one of the sisters.
This is one of the sisters?
Yeah.
I think it was very easy. It was very chilled out, the shoot. It was like a home, you know? Everyone on set, so many babies, children. So much used to be happening all the time.
Yeah.
The energy level was very high,
which
was really nice.
Shilpa?
Yeah, and also doing the scenes, you know, creatively, you're trying to work on a scene together. And it's lovely because script is at one level and then the actors and the director, everyone takes it to the other level and then all of us are together in it. And if we think this is working, it's working. It's not, okay, let's get rid of this. So there was a lot of openness.
So there was lots of collaboration.
Yeah, we really wanted it to we just wanted to deliver our best. And all of us were, just there for that.
The show has a line, every mom has a mantra. Which are some of the funniest or most innovative mantras you've heard a mom use, or Karisma in your case, that you've actually used?
There are many mantras, but I can't tell my secrets now.
Oh, this is too politically correct. No, just won't do. Do you have a mantra, Sandhya?
Just give me like a second, Shilpa.
I'm going to Shilpa.
Yeah, there is one funny, because I'm from Bihar, so in Bihar, we often say in a line, when children have to be scared, they say, "Lato ke bhoot baaton se nahi mante."
That reminds me of something my father used to say, when my brother used to demand and say, "Papa, Toyota khareed lo," in the daytime of Maruti or something, and whatever. Yeah, he wanted goodies, okay? And my dad would say, "Baap ne mari mend ki beta tirandaz." Which means, father ne to menda ki mara hai and the son wants to be a tirandaz?
Yeah.
Is a nacho. Sure.
Tell me some of the parental issues that the show touches upon.
Well, honestly, you need to watch this show, then aapko pata chalega. Ab yahan hum nahi bata sakte.
Yeah.
Aap mental ho, dekhiye to pata chalega.
But trust me, we are touching every parental
issue. A lot of, yes.
Every.
So your show comes out really soon. I'm going to ask you guys to talk very quickly about why you think everyone needs to tune in. And I'm going to start with Shilpa because she said the least on this.
Yeah, please.
Everyone should watch Mentalhood because it's year 2020. And here is a show where we are talking about, not just talking about, but making you go through an experience of emotions and catharsis that I think people have not had in a long time. I mean, these are real people, real characters, real matters, real issues. And so you will see yourself in it, and you will see that you're not alone, that the world is you and you're the world. And so welcome to Mentalhood.
It's the longest answer she's given all episodes.
Bus.
On that note, I'm guessing Karisma and Sandhya will throw me out and ask them any more questions.
No, but I have an answer to this question, which I want to.
I will ask you this
Why
question.
One must watch Mentalhood is because we are snack. And YOLO!
Yes. Now let's dip.
Now let's dip.
It's not motherhood.
Oh, I'm seriously mental.
It's Mentalhood.
Premiering on 11th of March, streaming on ZEE5.